Well, hello, God bless you, and look at this. I guess you're about to call me the flag preacher. Bishop Patrick L. Wood Sr. coming to you today with Old Glory in my hands. And I tell you, my friends, I am so excited about the upcoming celebration of the birth of this nation, the 4th of July. Listen, I'm going to tell you something. I thank God that I was born in the United States of America, more specifically, the state of North Carolina, the county of Richmond, the city of Rockingham, North Carolina. Oh my God, I thank God, the state of North Carolina. I thank God that I was born in this nation. And I want to say this. I want to say this to you. My friends, most of the people that you're hearing complaining about America, the major reason that they complain so much about America, my friends, is that they have lived nowhere else. And especially if you are like me, of African descent, and you're blessed to be born in America, let me tell you something. Don't you let nobody poison you against this nation, because much of what they're saying to us, they're not saying it to anyone else. They're training our people to be angry, to be upset, to fight the power. And while you're busy being angry and upset and fighting for nondescript things, you know, nondescript things like change. We want change. Change what? You want change for the better? Change for what does change mean? It's nondescript. It's too vague. And we're arguing over things. We're spending time protesting. And I'm not saying that you don't have the right, because we do. And I'm not saying that we shouldn't, because we should. But don't spend all of your time protesting, because let me tell you, others are spending their time getting ahead, buying property. Gentrification is taking place. We're being moved out. While we're standing, while we're marching about this, that, and the other, there are things going on. Talk to realtors. Talk to politicians. Talk to people who are in the know. There are things that are going on that's causing us to be left behind. Now, let me tell you something. The Bible is right. The Bible says in Proverbs chapter number 22 and verse 24, the Bible says, make no friends with an angry man, and with a furious man thou shalt not go. Don't link up with these people who are trying to keep you angry all the time. You know, Brother Gary, someone told me one time when I first moved to Raleigh, I heard someone say on the radio, and it sounded good, says, if you are a black man and you're living in America and you're not angry, then there's something wrong with you, that you're not socially aware of what's going on. And you know what I did, Saints? I tried that anger thing. So I'm going to walk around, I'm going to be mad, and we got rocks in my jaws, and I'm angry with everyone who doesn't look like me. And I tried that for about a few days. And you know what? I decided I was going to go back to living like the Bible says. You know, Bible says the joy of the Lord is your strength, that God gives us joy. Bible teaches that we are to rejoice. And you know what? I like living with joy much better, and I like living a life where I greet each person, I take each person, I deal with my encounters with each individual separately and based on their encounter with me, and I treat people the way I want to be treated, and I follow the word of God that says we're to love our neighbor as ourselves. And it didn't say black neighbor, white neighbor, brown neighbor, Asian neighbor, but to love our neighbors as ourselves. So I'm grateful today to be coming to you. And, the 4th of July is this weekend. So I want to wish you a happy Independence Day. And I want to say to everybody who's watching, man, you thank God that you were born here. And I want to say to America, you need to stay faithful. to the God of the Bible. The Bible says, blessed is that nation. Psalms 33 and verse 12. Blessed is that nation whose God is the Lord. Whose God is the Lord. And the people whom he hath chosen for his own inheritance. Let me tell you something. The greatness of America is that America has embraced Christianity with all of its flaws. And we have many. You have to admit, though, we've come a long way. I said this in the church the other day, and I'll say it again. The richest people in the world of African descent live in America. They built their wealth in America. They gained their prosperity in America. We won life's lottery when we were born in America. And check this out. In 1977, in America, I got born again. Now I'm saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Ghost, living in America. And you know what? Good things have come my way as a result of giving my heart to Jesus Christ and being born in a country where the Constitution allows us to worship freely, to serve the God of our choice. And you know, I'm serving the God of the founding of this great nation, and it's not perfect, but I tell you what, it's as close to perfect as any nation will ever get on this earth until, get this, the millennial reign of Christ, when Jesus Christ himself will come and he will rule the world. The lion is going to lay down with the lamb. Oh my, we'll study war no more. 1,000 years of Christ ruling this planet. And until then, we got things that we got to deal with. I think that when we run into rogue peace officers, police officers who do the wrong thing, prosecute them. But I'm not for defunding the police. I think when an individual does something that they shouldn't do, hold it against that individual. But I don't think you should blame a whole race. You know, I hate it when I'm profiled, because I'm profiled based on the actions of someone else. And as African-Americans, we've hated profiling. And yet now, through critical race theory and things like that, we're actually teaching people to judge all people by the behavior of people who live hundreds of years ago, by the behavior of things that took place that happened even before we were all born. My friends, we can't live like this. Now, I want you to enjoy the 4th of July, but I tell you what I really want you to do. I want you to meet me tonight here at the Upper Room Church of God in Christ. There is a word that God has given me. I tell you what I really want to do. I really want to throw a hint out there, but I'm not. But I tell you what, if you come, and at the conclusion of the service tonight, I'm going to pray. And God is going to anoint us with an anointing that will cause some good things to come our way. Yes, I'm excited about tonight. I'm excited about being back. I'm excited about getting an opportunity to share with you the word of the Lord. Last Thursday night, evangelist Emel Hope, actually the daughter of the founder of the Upper Room Church of God in Christ, one of his daughters, she ministered the word of the Lord, and she blessed us real good. And tonight, yours truly will be back, and I want you to join me here at the Upper Room Church of God in Christ for Bible study. Yes, sir. That's it. Bible study. We're going to study the word of the Lord together, and then I'm going to pray for you, and God is going to anoint you with an anointing that's going to follow you, and that's going to fix some things, and that's going to correct some things. The Lord dealt with me last night, and when I sought him, I said, God, what do I talk about? Where do I go from here? Because we spent our time in the month of June celebrating Jesus Pride Month, and we're not going to let it go. We're not going to let it go. We're going to talk because so many things are going on. Probably the next time, I need to get the picture. I want to show you a billboard, a sign that's on the side of the road, a huge billboard where some of these denominations have gone crazy. I guess they've just decided that the Bible doesn't count and the Word of God is no longer relevant. Well, if the Bible doesn't count and the Word of God is no longer relevant and the Bible is not right, then why are you inviting me to your church? Nah, just become something else. Become a nightclub. Become a social gathering. Because actually, that is what you are. Because when the Spirit of the Lord abandons a place, everything changes. My time's up. My time's up. I'm excited about tonight. Join me tonight. And listen, everybody who's watching, black, white, praise the Lord, whatever your ethnicity is, praise God. Listen, enjoy this country. You know, all the people who protest our country, they don't even realize, and they turn their back on the flag and all that kind of stuff. They don't even realize that they're blessed to be able to do that. Do you not know? If you tried that in China and other countries, I guarantee you, they wouldn't be able to find you anymore. Or when they finally do, when they do release you from the re-education camps, I guarantee you, you'll know not to do that anymore. One of our very fine members, a daughter, she's in school. I won't name the name of the school. I won't name the name of the young lady, but she's in school and she's there to major in some very difficult subjects that's much too much for me. But she called her parents the other day and said, you know, I'm not liking this. I want to come home. I'm not enjoying this. Because instead of them teaching us what we came to school to learn, which is a specific discipline, they're teaching us to be angry. They're teaching us critical race theory. They're teaching us to hate people who don't look like us. Now, if this is what they're teaching in universities, how in the world are we going to compete on the world stage with other nations who are teaching their kids real subjects, real discipline, real science, real math, real, you know, the things that make people, that educate people and give them things that, you know, that are marketable in the real world. Yes, in the real world. So don't you buy that. Now, I've gone long today. I've gone long. I'll wrap it up. I'll see you tonight right here at the Upper Room Church of God in Christ. God bless you. Make it a great day. I'm enjoying this flag right here with Old Glory. Get you one and display it proudly. God bless.